I'm going to show you how to create a roster of your staff's timesheets with linked timesheets. So we have here a list of employees and the hours that they have done. And then you have a total hours for the day, how many hours you have charged against you. And then at the end of the month, you have, at the end of the thing, you have a total hours for this each individual. Now, let's show you a few things what I've done here. So my start date is March 1st, 2018. So I could change that to April. And then all my weekends will change. And how I have done that is I've conditionally formatted this. I've got this whited out, but this equals weekday of C5, which is here. And if the weekday is either 1 or 7, 1 being Sunday and 7 being Saturday, it's grayed out. And basically how I did this, so let me change it back to March. I put each, so the first is equal to this cell here, but how I've increased the day is I've equal to just added 1 to the date. Now, how I formatted this is I formatted this format cells, and I went custom, and I'm just asking for the day. They know it's a date there, but the only thing I want to see is the day, so I want to see the letter, see the 1, 2, 3, up to 31, right? Okay, so now what I have here is for each of these individuals is I have an employee. I have employees. I have their actual timesheets linked here. So let's go to employee 1. And you can see there's an employee timesheet here. And here you have time in at 8, time out at 12, then he's back at 1. Now, it works particularly well if you use a 24-hour timesheet. And so then I've done the same thing with the days along the side here. And then I have created a formula here. And so what I've done is I've taken D3 minus C3, and then I've added F3 minus E3. And then because it's going to give you a fraction, what I've done is I've multiplied it by 24, and so you'll get the hours this way. Now, these are linked. So let's take, let's pretend this guy didn't work in the afternoon. So let's put 0 in here. And so he's got 4 hours. And so now I go back to my main sheet, and there you see that he's got 4 hours now on there. So this is how you link the timesheet. So basically all it is it equals an employee 1, and then it's got the cell that it's linked to. Now, your timesheets won't normally be on the same sheet as your roster is. So let me just show you something here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go and I'm going to copy this. So if you if your staff or have their own computers, you could have their timesheets on their individual computers. Now let's just change this to employee 3. So let's go 3. So what I'm going to do is this is a totally different workbook, and so now I'm going to go back to my roster. And so I'm going to go employee 3. So I'm going to go equals, and I am going to go to the other worksheet, and I'm going to click on the total for the day, first day. And as you can see now, it says book 1, because I haven't named this, sheet 1, and G3. And there you have the hours brought over to you. So you can link equally. Now, if you're in a network, everybody can have their timesheet on their own computer, and it would work just fine. So this is how you create a roster of employees with linked timesheets. This will be available if you'd like to get a copy of this. Just email me. Please subscribe.